saw the sun come up behind you. Inside your arms where I belong.
Here, Kelly.
Woo!
Frenchie Davis is in the house.
Davis is here. Love's got a hold on me. I love it. I love it. How are you? Man, well, thank you for stopping by. I know you've got a busy schedule. Okay, so what inspired this single? What inspired this song?
Well, a friend of mine, Janice Robinson, who's an amazing songwriter, she reached out to me shortly after my time on The Voice, and she was like, I wrote a song that it's just for you, and I honestly don't think anyone can sing it the way you would.
Whoa. And, so she heard you on The Voice then?
Oh, I met Janice back when I was in Rent, so I met her years ago, actually.
Okay.
And, you know, so when I went to New York for the Voice tour, I hooked up with her out there, and we recorded it in her studio. I loved it. We recorded it, and, you know, then I hooked up with Brian Friedman, and he wanted to help me with the video.
Huge shout out to him. An amazing choreographer.
It's beautiful. The music video is just beautiful.
I mean, it really couldn't have happened without Brian, without my best friend Terrell, without Sean Andre, because they really put the dancers together. They helped me do all of it, and really it was their belief in me that, you know, made them take the time out to help me put it together. So major shout outs to all of them.
That's so awesome.
I have a question.
Yeah.
And I'm going to throw this out because we always talk about people getting kind of, you know, pushed down and out, and then their struggle to come back. Mm-hmm. You know, American Idol had an issue with you.
Mm-hmm.
What was the issue?
The issue was that I took topless pictures when I was 19 years old.
Which happens to a lot of models.
It happens to a lot of, yeah, definitely,
and
in this entertainment.
What's interesting about them having an issue with it is the fact that they knew about it months before they decided to kick me off the show for it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So it was a nice little like thing for
It was
for
a nice
American
little plug
Idol.
For them.
Wow.
Right.
But being pushed off that, really, like, you came back full force.
Yes.
How did you manage that transition?
Well, I allowed myself the moment I needed to be sad, because there was definitely that, and I'd be lying if I didn't say that. And then allowing myself to have that moment pushed me to the moment where I was tired of being sad, and I was just ready to take control of my life, take control of my career, and focus on all the good. And, you know, I got cast in Rent on Broadway. I did the Broadway version of Dreamgirls.
Which is awesome, by the way, Dreamgirls.
Thank you.
Huge congrats.
Yes. Thank you. And I did Ain't Misbehavin', which our cast recording was nominated for a Grammy.
Woo.
And it was kind of the Grammy nomination for Ain't Misbehavin' that really made me start thinking, maybe I can still have a recording career, because I got a Grammy nomination without a record deal, so maybe this is still possible.
Oh, and, so that kind of inspired you again.
That right. kind of sprinkled the seeds, and then I was performing at a nightclub in West Hollywood, and the casting director for The Voice happened to be in the audience that night, and she told me that she thought I was great, and that they didn't care about my past, and that she would love if I would consider auditioning for the show. And I did, and, you know, of course my initial reaction was like, I don't want to relive the
drama.
Right.
Yeah, because
I don't want to relive that.
Right.
But, you know, it's just, you know, it's proof that sometimes you got to take chances, even if you're scared. You know, you're never going to get to where you want to get to if you're afraid to take a chance. And, you know, I decided to take a leap of faith and be on the show. And, you know, I thought I was going to go on there and get to sing all these soulful songs. And the producers and Christina kept giving me dance music, and it kept charting on the iTunes dance charts, and I'm thinking, okay, well, this is opening a whole other
thing that
window
you didn't
of possibility
think, yeah.
for me.
Which was kind of out of your comfort zone, of course.
Yeah, it was.
Which is, it kind of prepared you for a great time, though, because it's all about dance music right now.
Exactly.
Do you know what I mean? Like,
it
that is.
Is
what is selling right
yes.
now.
Yeah.
So it
and
set
I'm
you up for a good situation.
It did, and I'm actually a huge fan of dance music, and I became a fan of dance music, you know, 10 years ago when it was Martha Wash and CeCe Peniston and Jocelyn Brown and Robin S. and all of those divas. So I'm excited to kind of bring that big voice over banging dance track genre, whatever we call that. I'm really excited.
No, I'm from Chicago. I grew up on house music, so we love the big booming voices and that sound. So I'm just glad that, you know, you're here with us today and also to talk about it from a really honest perspective. And I think what you said was so awesome about, you know, not being scared to take chances.
Yeah.
You know, and to go through it. We talk about it all the time, just in talking about business. Like, go through the process. Mm-hmm. If you're feeling something, feel it, but then
allow yourself to feel it, but move on.
Yes.
And that's the most important part.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's nothing written that says you have to be dishonest with yourself or anybody else about how you feel.
Mm-hmm.
Allow yourself to feel it, because sometimes those feelings are going to be beautiful, they're going to be ugly, and you allow yourself to feel it, and then you move on.
Mm-hmm.
And
who helps you move on? Because sometimes it's also your support system.
Mm-hmm. I have a great support system. I have a sister. We're 2 years apart, and it's amazing how we went from childhood rivals to BFF as adults, you know, and she's a huge, huge part of my support system. My best friend, who's also my makeup artist and sometimes my stylist, we've been best friends since we were 15 years old.
Wow.
I'm really close to both of my parents. I have the same friends from college. One of my best friends from college is my executive assistant now, and, you know, it's just...
Well,
you
were building your team very young. Like,
yeah, exactly. I didn't even know that I was.
Didn't even know it.
And
didn't
it just,
even know
and again,
it.
Again, you know, I believe in a higher power, and, you know, I'm a spiritual person, and I just definitely think that fate, you know, God, the universe, whatever, you know, people believe in, I really think that, you know, it was preparing me all this time and putting my team in place. And, you know, I'm really thankful.
Well, you're very lucky to have a makeup and stylist. We were talking about that earlier about how... we were going back and forth with Aaron about whether he should wear a vest or not, whether vests are in or not.
I'm gonna borrow your friends.
Yes, so all my friends. Sure,
we might have to like schedule a meeting or something.
Okay, definitely.
So now that you've got this great song out, this great video out, and everybody, you guys have to check it out. Like, especially all my dance friends who watch this show, you gotta check this out. What's the next step? What's the next step for Frenchie?
I'm gonna keep putting out, you know, great dance songs.
Okay.
You know, I want to bring good singing back to the industry, but I still want to make people dance.
Yeah.
And those are the two things that I'd like to merge, you know, with my sound, I guess. And so I'm looking forward to, you know, I'm staying in the studio, putting together Christmas music right now. And I've been in talks about possibly starting my own plus-size lingerie company.
Hey, speaking of which.
And I don't know if you saw on Twitter, last week we had Rosie Mercado of Curvy Girls, a new show. Curvy Girls loves you. They have been tweeting all about you.
Oh, wow.
I'm telling you, gotta link up with Rosie Mercado.
I will.
Look her up. They've been supporting you since they found out we were going to do this interview, and I thought the synchronicity in that.
She's doing
a Curvy
Girl thing too.
Yes,
yeah.
They love
Hi, let's
you.
Hook up.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's a new show that's on Nuvo, and it's four girls, plus size models.
I love that.
And it's about their whole life and like the misconceptions of, you know, just because you're plus size model, they think, oh, well, you don't have to work hard. You don't have to do anything. You know what I mean?
They think that, you know, let me tell you, if you go to my house, you're going to see an elliptical and a treadmill right there in the living room. That's my couch. No, I'm dead serious.
Right.
And there's this, you know, misconception that if you're bigger, you're lazy and you sit around eating all day. And, I mean, my partner, she's like tall, skinny, and she eats cupcakes for
all
no reason.
Cupcakes.
And I'm like, are you kidding me? Or
I
like,
hate it
know,
when Kelly could do that right in front of me. She's like,
Ava Marcel, who's one of my... best friends, and she won season 2 of Top Model.
Oh.
She's a supermodel, and we went to the cafeteria in Chelsea in New York. I ordered like grilled salmon and a spinach salad, and she ordered the fried chicken and waffles.
See, that's
and with macaroni and cheese.
Is that right?
Yes. Yeah. And Eva's about, what, a size 2? A size 0?
That's
just not right.
Skinny girls be eating.
Not,
like, I don't know
fair.
Where this... I don't know where this foolishness came from, because all my skinny friends eat. Like, my friend, my assistant is like 97 pounds, and she will walk in the house with, like, McDonald's. Like, hey, girl. Like, bitch.
No, but you are telling the truth. You are telling the truth. You are telling the truth.
You know I am.
So you have got to look up Rosie, and I know Rosie's watching, and I know Curvy
Hi,
Girls
Rosie,
is watching.
Which we're also going to see at our yacht fashion show with the Fashion Destination. They're going to include Rosie Mercado, and maybe we can.
Yeah, we've got a huge
yacht
show. Yeah,
September
it's gonna
29th.
Be fun.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we got to take a quick break, but definitely follow Frenchie Davis. We're going to have a little bit more of her still, but follow her on Twitter at Frenchie Davis. You also have like a few Facebooks.
I have my regular Frenchie Davis Facebook, facebook.com/MissFrenchie, and then my fan page, which is Official Frenchie Facebook.
And iTunes. Go, what you're listening to right now is just a sample of what you can go get.
It just makes you want to dance. It really does.
So we're going to dance.
Yeah.
Go, Aaron.
Right
come
on
Aaron.
Into the break, but dance right back here to Live with Aaron and Kelly. I always felt your love amazing. Knew from the day you said to me, love's got a hold on me. Don't wanna let me.
Yes.
Welcome back.
I saw the sun come up. Ooh, I'm gonna have to start dancing, seriously. Inside your arms where I belong. I felt my life completely moving. A million birds into the dawn. Just wanna run away forever. It's like a party in here. Welcome back to Live with Aaron and Kelly. We've got Aaron dancing. That's right. We got Susie Garcia and Frenchie Davis and your girl Kelly V. Dolan. That's right. Sing along, everybody.
Awesome! We had a live. I don't know how, man. Oh, it just got hot in here. The electricity is all around us. You're watching Live with Aaron and Kelly. That's right. Well, this is our time where we kind of bring back our guests and we play a little game called Taboo.
I love
Have you played
that game.
Taboo before?
I haven't.
Okay, so let's explain the rules. What are the rules?
The rules are you get one word at the top, and then there's about five words at the bottom, and you cannot say those words at the bottom, but you try to get the other person to guess what that top word is.
Okay. Without saying those words.
Without
so I'm going to have to monitor
words.
You.
So what are we going to do team-wise? Who
okay,
are we
so
do?
Will you pick who you want?
Oh, Aaron,
I'll
I can't do that.
Dibs.
I can't do that.
We should do Team Guarita. Because we're both blondie.
Sounds good.
Okay,
all right.
Then I got Frenchie.
Team Guarita. Right.
Okay.
Team Guarita.
Right.
Team Guarita.
Okay, let's do this. All right,
I love it.
First of all, I just got to say, Frenchie, you and me, we're connecting right now.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, we're going to make this happen.
It's all about Guaritas.
Guarita power.
Guarita power. Guarita power.
Guarita. Okay.
I just want to say that word.
You have a minute to get as many as you can, okay?
Okay.
So I am going to, so you guys go first, okay?
Okay, we're
going
to go
Are
first.
Are you ready, Kelly?
Yes.
Okay, ready?
Is that the word?
That's the word.
Okay,
ready,
got
go.
It. Sometimes when people want to relax or laugh, they do what? Oh, yeah.
Drink.
Something else.
Smoke.
What is somebody that does that, what are they called? What? Hey.
A tweaker.
Keep going. Hey.
A stoner.
Yeah.
You got it.
You got it.
All right.
What?
Nice.
Oh, come on.
How about that one?
Okay, sounds good. If we go down to San Diego Shed Aquarium.
Shed. What? Oh, she just said the word. That was the word. Aquarium, people.
Where's the buzzer?
Okay, wait. Hold on. This
wait. Okay.
Guarita, Guarita. What are you doing?
Guarita is struggling
okay,
right now.
One. Go for it. 15 seconds.
Three. Okay, if it's hot, what you need what?
A bathing suit.
No.
Water.
In your house. What do you
air
have?
Air conditioner.
Got it.
All right, good.
If I'm a
3 seconds.
If I'm a breaker, I do one of these. What's
Dance.
It called?
A jerk. A snake.
No.
But I just want to see.
I don't
you
know why I went with the breaker
really,
thing.
Yeah, what was that about?
What
that
is it?
A backflip.
Backflip.
She couldn't say gymnast or cheerleader.
Thank
so.
You. Thank you,
yeah.
Frenchie.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So, all right. Now it's my turn. Okay. I'm hearing delay here, so maybe we can. Okay. There we go. So now, Who's my teammate? Okay. Who else is in here?
You just said you connected with her.
I know. In my head.
I forgot about it.
Okay. All right. All right.
This game is very difficult.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You need to time me. But you need to make sure I don't say the words because I'm
going to say
it. I
got you. Ready?
Okay. Ready?
What are we doing? 1 minute?
Yeah.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, you started. Okay. When you go to Japan and Godzilla, where are you at? Godzilla!
When I go to Godzilla.
Where does he go? Where does he put his.
This Tokyo.
Yes, exactly.
Good!
Good job. When I go to Magic Mountain and I get on a
roller
thing.
Coaster?
Yes. Awesome.
Oh, wait. Okay. We're starting.
This is a type of, like, it's not a vegetable, but it's like a green little thing with a fuzzy stuff around it, and it's got a lot of little seeds around.
So it's a fruit?
Yeah.
So
yes.
So is it a kiwi?
Yes, which I can't. Yes!
Okay.
Oh, that's it.
No, I can't do that. What the heck is that?
That's that Howard University right there. Y'all ain't ready.
Wait a minute.
Wait. When somebody wants to when they want to go to McDonald's, then they want to take in a lot of or
calories.
What are they? Yeah, but they're doing what? What are they doing?
I don't
with
see the word.
I know it was there.
Fast
but,
food.
Consume. I didn't know how to say consume. Sorry.
That's hard. Consume. That's hard.
That was a hard one.
Okay, so now how are we going to do this?
Okay.
I think we won. I mean,
well, they definitely won. They definitely beat us.
Right. Yes.
Do we do
I think that's it. I think that was enough. Do you really want to? I think that.
It's fine. We'll concede.
I mean,
got smacked.
We don't need to count the points.
We don't need to count the points?
That's really nice of you, Frenchie.
We don't want to be sore winners.
I know. That's true. Okay. All right. How many did you get, girls get?
Two.
Two. Oh, I'm just saying they might rewind it. I don't want to have to have them. So 3-2. That's right. We won. Yeah.
That's okay. That's okay. Ours were really tough.
I lost last week.
You guys did have
I keep losing.
And that was my first time playing, so I didn't know what to expect.
Right,
exactly, exactly.
We connected.
Yeah. Don't you love how people who lose always make all the excuses? We're always like, well, it was really hard. Right. And then, like, I've never played before.
Yeah,
so
you know, for the first time, that wasn't bad.
It wasn't.
She's the queen of positivity.
You know, and I like that. Now, let's talk. We've got two singers in the house, which I just, it just happened literally. We didn't plan that.
I love Spanish music.
Thank you.
Like, I love it. I don't understand it yet, but I sing with pretty good diction.
Good.
And you don't have to understand it.
Suavemente, bésame.
Whoa, do it.
Suave, besándome otra vez. Suave, besame, besame. Suave, besame otra vez. Te quiero tus labios, besándome otra vez. Besa, besa, besa un poquito. Besa, 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 besame otro ratito.
Yeah.
She's good. You need to be in my all-female mariachi group.
Frenchie Davis, let's do
it.
We need to do that.
And we need to make a song and a dance kind of cumbia, and then you'll record.
Hello.
We just hooked up three different curvy girls. Mariachi, dude, this is
done.
How we do it.
Let's
done.
Go.
That's what the world needs, a black girl in a mariachi band.
There
you
go.
What is missing from America. We are doing
that. We need to cross borders.
High five.
Whoa. That's how we do it right here, live with Eric.
This moment was more epic than,
cultural
than Clinton's speech last night. This moment right here was more epic than that.
You got the violin going on. Do you play any instruments by any chance?
I play a little bit of piano, a little bit of guitar by ear, but vocals are definitely my instrument.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very cool.
We can see, huh?
Yeah.
Wow. She blows it out. I got to ask, working with Christina Aguilera, obviously a moment in history for you.
Absolutely. Yeah. I think.
Did it go by so quick, or were you able to at least enjoy the moments?
You know what? I think that moment, when we were in rehearsals for Lady Marmalade, that was like, wow, like I'm in rehearsals. I'm getting ready to go sing Lady Marmalade with Christina Aguilera. Like, this is crazy.
And, yeah.
You know, it's like 10 years after being on Idol, like all of this is happening. Mm. And it's just amazing. It just goes to show you, like, when you are born to do something, like that's what you're going to do, no matter what gets in your way.
Do you agree?
Viva. Yeah. No, it's in your soul. It's in your heart. Mm-hmm. And I'm not sure why, you know, I started playing the violin. I'm not sure why I started to get into mariachi music, but I do feel like that was what I was born to do.
Yeah.
And if I'm not going to sing it, I'm going to promote it. I'm going to make sure everybody knows about it. So that's what I believe. I believe it's just in my soul.
It is. Aww. And that's what makes you a singer.
Absolutely.
Really. When it's in here.
It's in here.
And you know you were born to do it.
Absolutely. The people have to feel what you do. Mm-hmm. And the only way they're going to do that is if you feel what you do.
Ooh. And that's what separates entertainers from singers. Mm-hmm. Right there.
There you go. Mm. She said it, everyone. Mm.
Yeah.
That is. It is. And that's what we strive to do, right?
Yeah. It's all about the connecting. If you don't feel that it is important, then people tuning in or people listening aren't going to feel that it's important. Like, even as I'm listening to your, both of your music, it's like, oh, it makes me want to dance because mm-hmm. there's something coming from you that's truthful. There's something that you're feeling and it's making me feel it because yeah. we're all connected in some sense.
Yes, we are.
So when you tap into that higher purpose and you tap into the truth, people feel it mm-hmm. and they don't tap into stuff that's fake. You know, I'm not going to say what singer, but I remember reading an article on a singer that she went through a lot of stuff and it came out in her music and now she's really happy. And so that's coming out. But people have always listened to her music because she was always truthful at that the time she was writing, mm-hmm. you know, and it was coming from that true place. So I think it's awesome. I know we have to wrap up things. We do have a lot of young listeners and viewers out there. Mm-hmm. What is some advice that you could give to them if they're passionate about something? What's some advice that you can give to them? Obviously, you guys are on your way up and in going higher in the levels of entertainment and success in your own personal life. What's some advice that you can give to them?
I would say that, you know, stand firm in believing that you're enough because while you're pursuing your dreams, you're going to cross paths with people who always want to convince you that you're not enough, that you're not pretty enough, that you're not thin enough, that you're not tall enough, that your skin's not light enough. Like they'll try to convince you always that you're not enough. And so you have to believe and stand firm in the belief that you are indeed enough and that you don't have to be anybody else. Like I always say, like, you're not who they say you are. You're who God says you are. And you can do anything. Mm-hmm. And that's what I would say to young people.
Mm. For me, I would just say to, you know, dare to dream. Keep dreaming. Mm-hmm. Without the dreams, we don't have anything. We have nothing to look forward to. We have nothing to aspire to. So it's just, you know, keep dreaming and really think about who you are mm-hmm. and where you came from. Don't forget about that. Because
yeah.
that really is, you know, our heart and soul. And that's what's going to keep us grounded and keeping in this beautiful city thriving.
Yeah. I gotta say as well, Susie, we didn't really get to plug that you really helped. You put this whole event together.
I did. I produced.
You're the producer.
I am the executive producer. That's the awesome. Vision is here, and again, it's the dream. I had this baby dream about telling the world about Nati Cano and Los Camperos, the best mariachi in all of Los Angeles, and who taught me at UCLA. I mean, he was my mentor, my teacher, and he taught me so many things about generosity and culture and tradition and dreaming. He dreamt that he could come to this city and show people what his music was all about. And now he's given this gift to all of us. So, yeah.
And when is that event? One more time.
One more time. It's September 15th at the Ford Theater in Hollywood at 8 p.m. on September 15th. We hope you come out. It's going to be a wonderful, beautiful cultural event. And it's on the Mexican Independence Night. So viva, viva Mexico, viva la tradición.
Viva!
Viva!
We got a lot of vivas in the house.
Yeah. All right. And then Frenchie, one more time, if you want to plug anything, your website, any Twitter.
Yeah, hit me up at Frenchie Davis on Twitter or officialfrenchie.com for bookings. FrenchieDavis.org.
Frenchie Davis.
Yes.
And go get that CD.
Go download that single.
Go get it.
Go to
go
iTunes.
Get it.
If you have a Droid, go to Amazon. It's available everywhere.
And I'm at esaguarita.com, and my Twitter's esaguarita as well. You can go to iTunes as well. Look up esaguarita.
You heard it here.
That's right. And if you guys, seriously, if you guys are looking for the best news in entertainment, it is right here live with Aaron and Kelly.
There you go.
We are speaking to some of the next generation of singers, business people, artists, and you've got two of them right here, two beautiful, lovely ladies. So make sure to tune in every Thursday at 2 o'clock for Live with Aaron and Kelly. Follow Aaron M. Sanchez and Kelly V. Dolan on Twitter and Facebook.
And we're watch us on Mikasa Broadcasting, always, three times a day, every Thursday. We will be back next week.
That's
thank
right.
You.
Thank you guys for all your support, and thank you guys so
thank
much
you.
For coming KCA, on Live with Aaron
thank
and
you.
Kelly.
Thank
thank you.
So
bye bye. Thank
Aaron,
you.
Aaron, you got to get up and dance.
Thank you. Wait, you said salsa.
No,
wait,
you promised you would get up and dance.